Hey, everybody, we're back again. You know who we are. Hey, we're talking. We got T-shirt Bob here and Travis Teal Page Music.
What's up?
Travis, thank you for being on the show again. I mean,
absolutely.
It's pretty cool that your wife is kind enough to let us have you for three nights out of the week. I mean, you got a small infant in the home that is probably, you know, in need of its daddy. You have a daughter? Yeah, I was going to say. I said it.
I have a daughter.
I sound like a jackass. It's a daughter.
No, how's it doing, Travis? Is everything okay with it?
Travis, how old is your daughter?
She was born December 28th, so she is just over, she's about a month and a week or two, I guess.
That means she's 5 weeks old. Come on, Travis.
No, that does not mean she's 5 weeks old. I'm trying to think of what today is.
Gotta do the weeks.
What's today?
Yeah, she's 8 weeks old at this point. I don't know, 6 weeks?
She's like 2 months, 2 months old.
Yeah.
Like 1 to 2 months. Who cares?
But you got to say weeks. That's how they all do it. You can't say months.
Dude,
you can't
say anything. I'm not good enough at math. I'll just, in lieu of that, I'll just like, let me see if we can get a nice little picture going.
Oh, look at that cutie.
She's adorable. Okay. She is. And that's it. Yeah.
All right. So Travis is on the show. I'm going to play a song right away. And I love this song. So I'm going to blast it. Get ready. Here we go. This one is from Travis's album called We Missed It. It's an EP. You can get it on iTunes and every place else, but we want you to go to iTunes. We want to help out Travis. We want to make more money for Travis. So go to iTunes and pick this up. It's available now. We Missed It. Travis Teal Page. This is Family off of We Missed It. All right, you know what? I don't know. I'm sure you did mention the person, but who played drums?
Oh, I totally forgot. Oh my gosh!
Thanks a lot, jerk.
Oh my goodness! Yeah, he's gonna hate me. Ryan Rich played drums.
That's such a great name.
Yeah, Ryan Rich, and he is absolutely. I think everybody would be okay with us saying he's absolutely. I can't believe I forgot. He's absolutely the best musician out of anyone that touched any sort of music, you know, musical instrument on this album. He is far more talented than anybody that played. He's a guy that's just can play everything. I mean, he's immensely talented. He lives in Dallas now.
Okay,
and so yeah,
so you've got quite a few Texas people on the album too. That's interesting.
None of them were Texas people. Texas is a black hole that just steals everything. And so all of these people were St. Louis people, and we were all like, you know, good friends. And then over the course of a few years, everybody just like not really scattered, but you know, Logan was in Atlanta. He's back in St. Louis now, but Logan was in Atlanta. Ryan and Taylor both moved to Texas. Now Ryan's in Dallas, and Taylor's in Austin, but me and Peter are holding St. Louis strong. But they're all St. Louis people.
As you said, you know, St. Louis is making a comeback, right?
Oh, bro, never left, man. We are here.
It's popping.
St. Louis is popping, man. Don't let the media fool you, bro. St. Louis is where it's at. Okay?
Part of the thing is people want to be warm, so they go to places like Texas and South Carolina and stuff
that
like that.
That is true. I swear to you, it was 70 degrees yesterday, and it snowed like super hard today for like 20 minutes. So it was insane. Like today is like the epitome of Missouri weather. Like it's crazy.
We were at 54 degrees and then we got 3 inches of snow the next day. It's like, yes. What are you talking about? What's going on here? But it's been a mild winter. Been a mild winter overall. Yeah. Really not going to complain about
it. You should knock on your table after you say that. Because from living in Michigan, I can tell you one thing. I can remember many times when Easter rolled around and it snowed. And I was just like, I hate this place. I mean, listen, I love Detroit. Will always be, I didn't live in the actual city of Detroit, let's be real, but Detroit will always be my home. Okay. I love where I'm from, but I don't like the weather. So I got the heck out of there. So there you go. All right. Let's talk a little bit about that. I love that song. First of all, I won't make you go, you know, totally in depth. You can say whatever you want, but that song to me, again, I think we talked about this. I'm not a huge, like, really dive into the lyrics of songs usually. I listen to it first and I just kind of get a feel for it. My wife's the exact opposite. She's always like, did you hear the words? And I'm like, no, I didn't even I don't know anything you said. But that song sounds like it's pretty deep to me. I didn't listen to all the words, but tell me a little bit about it. I love the hook on it is just phenomenal, dude. That's great. Yeah. I love it.
Thank you. Thanks. Well, I think this song is kind of the song that influences the entire album. It's the first song that I wrote on the record, and it just, without like getting crazy, I like people listening to a song and without sounding like an absolute douchebag. Like I don't want to like fill in all the answers for you because I like it. You know, somebody else, it could mean something to someone completely different than it means to somebody else. And so I like that that's there. I like that dynamic a lot, but it's absolutely the song that influenced the entire record because it comes from a place of, just honesty and, just being real with questions and, hangups. And my wife and I, she more than I come from a church background, and there was a distinct moment in my life where that was not me anymore. I was like, I'm done with all this. I can't fake it. I think all this is absolute bull crap. Like, I don't believe anything anymore. And so it was a distinct like shift in our marriage, and a distinct shift in my life, and so that's kind of where it comes from. It's just I'm not okay believing things that I don't believe anymore, saying I believe these things when I absolutely don't believe them. Mm-hmm. And that is kind of how the entire, that's how the entire EP is kind of tracked from. Like I'm being honest finally about what I think about religion. And it's not like a horror. I don't think religion is bad. My wife and I still go to church. And so it's not you know, some people will probably listen to that and be like, yeah, F it all, man. The hell, you know, the hell with that. But it's just being honest in the best way I can about, and the only way I know how to be honest about church and marriage and life and all of those things. Like my buddy put it best when he's just like, it just sounds like you're kind of coming clean on a lot of stuff. And for me, that's what this EP was, is just really just being honest about stuff. Sometimes for the first time. So, yeah.
Yeah. It's, you know, I'll just tell you, you know, I think everybody, you're younger than me. So, you know, you're going through the stuff that I think all of us go through as we get older. The things that we learned and the traditions that we grew up in, there's a point where you just, you know, you start to think, is this really what it is? Is this what life's all about? Are these things that I was taught, and are these things, you know, you start to question things, and that's awesome, man. I mean, that's just part of becoming who you are.
And for sure.
So I don't think that's a bad thing at all.
And you almost have to go back and experience things from your perspective, not what you've been taught your whole life. So
absolutely.
Just kind of taking, not getting into much detail, but the whole religious thing. You know, I know a lot of people that were brought up a specific way, and they, as they got older, they just drew away from that way, the way that, mm-hmm. that they were taught their whole life. But then once they did that, there was an awakening, and they found a different relationship with faith instead of just religion, and they went from their own perspective, and it changed, you know, everything that they see, and they were kind of awakened. So it's cool to see that, and not saying that this song plays it down that road, but I mean there is an avenue of that to where you may have felt like you've been faking it for so long, but now there comes a time where you realize what you truly believe and what you truly are, or what your goals are, mm-hmm. all of that stuff. So that's cool to see.
I would just say to, you know, like we say on this show, we've always kind of just said we will go where the show takes us. We have some ideas of what we want to talk about, but I would just say I think the main issue that most people have with people that are quote unquote religious is that they're fake people, and that they aren't. They don't live in reality. They try to pretend like they have their shit together. And the truth is, I don't think anybody has their shit completely together. You can mm-hmm. you can be a successful person in many different areas of your life, but we're all in process, man. None of us have it all figured out. So yeah. I would just say that's the biggest thing, is people are just looking for people who are authentic, and they are who they are. So and especially in the times that we're living right now, we need more people who are just going to be like, hey, this is what I think. I don't know if I got it all figured out, but can we talk about it without yelling at each other? Can we can we have a discussion and kind of start to come to some common places where we can say we love each other and all that kind of stuff? So, I'm getting too preachy here.
That's good. I'll take it.
This got very emotional.
I'm going into my preacher mode. Look out. I used to do some preaching in my day. And then I said shit and stuff like that. And they were like, you can't do that no more. And I was like, oh, okay. All right. So, Travis, before we completely go off the reservation here, let's ask you really quick. What are, since this is supposed to be Top 5 Friday, let's just pretend we're sticking to sort of the plan.
Deal.
Give us your top 5 influences. If you don't have 5, Bob will come up with some other stuff. He usually gives us like 10 or 20 when we say top 5. So, give us a couple of your influences musically.
My influences, not necessarily who I sound like, but my influences would absolutely be mostly singer-songwriters. I would say musically influences are a guy named David Ramirez. Not super popular guy, but I would recommend everybody check him out.
I can remember you actually posting some stuff about him.
Oh my gosh.
I knew he would show up.
Whew, he's so good, man. A little more popular, probably not mainstream. A guy named Noah Gunderson. Super great, but more kind of along the, you know, popular lines are Jason Isbell is definitely a big influence of mine. I would say older style, like I've been listening to a ton of Joni Mitchell, like just incredible, like songwriting. Trying to think.
One more, you got it. Come on, one more.
Man, I don't know. Influences is tough because you're like, I don't even think I sound anything like Joni Mitchell or Jason Isbell or anything like that.
You gave the disclaimer at the beginning. This is not who I sound like, so we know that. We're saying like what?
I just hate being talked about in the same.
Yeah.
Who inspires you?
That's
really what it is.
Yeah. Like I would, if anyone did anything from these two podcasts, I would say go listen to Noah Gunderson, Jason Isbell, and David Ramirez. Those are the people that like I listen to their music and I'm like, I am nowhere. Not musically, in just life. In life in general, I am nowhere when I listen to their music because they wreck me every time.
But
and then,
the
I don't
great
know.
Thing
let me,
is,
me,
you're
let me
you,
give
man.
More.
That's what we want. Sure. We don't want those other guys. We want you.
And then I'm looking literally in my like recently played right now because I need to see who.
Taylor Swift.
I listen to a lot of R&B, which is weird.
No, it's not.
Oh, and then an easy influence would be Drew Holcomb, if you guys have ever heard of Drew Holcomb and the Neighbors. No, okay. I'm striking out.
So let me ask you this. Yeah. No, you gave us good. No, those are yours. Don't back down. I like this. Okay. Now here's my last question though.
Yeah.
Can you remember who or like a band or something like that, that literally just made you want to be a musician? Think back when you were young, cause I'm sure you started doing music at a young age. Is there anybody that you were just like, I love this and this is what I want to be when I grow up?
Man, I'm trying to think.
And Scott, amazing.
I know, I go so deep, don't I? Bob, who's yours? Who made you want to be a drummer, Bob? We'll give Travis a minute.
Probably John Bonham from Led Zeppelin, just because he was one of those crazy far out drummers that did crazy stuff that nobody ever heard of. Ringo Starr, another one.
Ringo, Ringo doesn't get a lot of credit.
No, and he was one of the most creative, amazing drummers. More new school, which is so stupid.
Dave Matthews, you know you're going to say him. Go ahead.
Carter Beaufort from Dave Matthews Band, who's a very dynamic, amazing drummer.
Don't drummers always have to say Neil Peart at some point?
I mean, they do, but Neil Peart ain't at the top of my list. So, is he a great drummer? Yeah. Is he absolutely amazing? Yeah. But Rush wasn't a huge influence on my music style or ability. So, it's all over the place. And then I start getting into some jazz stuff and some blues stuff.
Oh, and look at him. Now look at how he's trying to give us jazz influences and stuff. And you're so cool.
Then it gets just crazy after that.
Man, you are so
That's
cool.
hilarious.
I don't even know how I get to be friends with you. Do you like jazz? Okay, Travis, give us one. Just throw it out there.
I was hoping that we would just run that for a little bit. I don't know. Like,
you're lying. I mean, who did you go see? Have you ever gone? It doesn't matter who it is, even if it's embarrassing. Who did you go see in concert? Like, who was your first concert you went to?
Oh, man, I have no idea.
Hootie and the Blowfish. We're not going to get upset.
No,
okay.
I promise you. I wish. Like, everybody
has these
moments.
He went to go
see
John Mayer like 15 times. I know he did.
I've seen John Mayer before, and it was an amazing show. And I will stand by that every time.
Travis was like, he was almost seduced by John Mayer. That's a guarantee.
Oh, man.
He wanted to kiss him right on the mouth.
I would have followed him anywhere.
Jack Johnson, something?
No, I would say early. Like, the earliest memories I have are listening to Boys to Men. Like, that is the early. And I sound nothing. Like, if you are like, I love Boys to Men, I'm going to go buy the We Missed It EP. That is not at all what you're in for. But that is those are the first memories I have of, like, they had this like legacy CD that I my mom got me when I was like a little kid. Oh my gosh, I loved their music. And like I think that's why I like R&B so much today. Mm-hmm. Like D'Angelo from the 90s, the Voodoo album of Brown Sugar. Those are like my jams. Phenomenal, dude.
I R&B love that Jesus. All these things that you're saying, you're like, oh, when I was a kid. And I'm like, oh, you mean when I was graduated from high school?
Dude, that's hilarious.
Oh my gosh, Boys to Men. Man. I was like, hey, we didn't have dances at my school, but yeah, because I went to a Christian school. Good grief. All the things you miss because of that.
I know.
Stinking Christians.
That's actually not what I said before. Is not, if I can get one thing from people here, not to buy my album, go listen to D'Angelo, the Voodoo album. And it will change your life.
Dude,
it'll
that's probably life. The best thing that's happened on this show is you talking about D'Angelo and Boys.
Bro, he is so good. He's such a genius. Like, he is like amazing. Everybody that like played on that Voodoo album is now like Pino Palladino, his bass player, plays for John Mayer Trio.
Listen to this. You guys are so fun. You geek about music. It's so great.
That is like one of the best records of all time.
Okay. All right. I'll have to believe you. Isn't Nelly from St. Louis or something like that?
Heck yes, he is.
Dude, you got to be
into
Nelly.
That is the only
Nelly,
person
right?
we got, man. Huh?
That's it? Hot and Her is the only guy you got?
No, we got Nelly. We've got Nelly. There's a guy.
he just keeps saying Nelly.
I'm trying to think of Nelly's real name. So
I don't
just,
know
like,
what it is.
On you. I have no idea either.
Okay.
We've got, there's a guy named Pokey Lafarge.
Look at that. Bob is like writing all these down. He can't wait.
Pokey Lafarge plays music like old time music. It's funny. It's like almost ironic. He plays like ironic old music, like old country, you know, music that was played in like the 40s.
That's fun.
But, yeah. St. Louis is, you know, amazing, but we really don't have a whole lot of musicians that have made it big that
you
have come out.
You know who
those
you do have? You know who, do we you have? Know who St. Louis has? Travis LePage.
Yeah. Yes, we do have that.
And but you mentioned Kingly and Lalo. Are they both
Lalo, yes. Yeah. Kingly and Lalo.
Are they from all from St. Louis?
All from St. Louis. St. Louis
Plank. Can't forget Peter Plank.
Peter Plank, absolutely. St. Louis has has an amazing music scene. It's just very
trying to sell us on St. Louis. We are not coming there.
I love St. Louis. People are like, I love St. Louis. I spend all of the time I can talking about how amazing St. Louis is.
They don't even have a football team.
Oh. We don't even want to. We don't. The hell with the Los Angeles Rams.
Hey, they have a big ass stadium that's empty. So
absolutely, we do. I'll play my first show there. That's what I'll do. I'll play a show at Scott Trade Center.
There you go.
With like two people, but and we might be getting an MLS team. So you know that's.
Dude, I mean, how can you go wrong with soccer?
I won't watch a game. I promise you.
Okay. All right. We went way over, but it was fun because we got to talk about D'Angelo and Boys to Men.
We should just take it another 30 minutes and just talk about brown sugar. For 30 straight minutes.
I wish we wouldn't get bumped off of YouTube and we could play some D'Angelo, but we can't. So we can only play your music because you let us. You're here. So if YouTube's like, hey, you can't play Travis Teal Page's music, we'll be like, he was there, dude.
Right. Exactly.
Suck it, YouTube. All right. Thanks for being here, Travis. We really appreciate you. Make sure you guys go out and get We Missed It. It's an EP, and it's from Travis Teal Page. Check him out on Instagram, Travis Teal Page Music. And you can get this on iTunes. You can get it at Apple Music, Spotify, Amazon, whatever the googly schmoogly does for music. And can't forget Tidal. I don't know why that's like so fascinating to me, but you can get it on Tidal.
It was just an option. I was like, why would I not have my music on Tidal?
I know, why not?
Like that one, those two people that are on Tidal, I'm just trying to bless their lives, you know?
Totally. I'm with you, man.
Because they're on that dial-up AOL internet, and once they finally get to Tidal, they're like, yes!
So finally made it.
I'll end the show on this, but I actually had somebody that is someone my age sent me an email today from AOL.com. And I was like, what? Does that exist?
I've got AOL. I have a friend. His last name is Friend, which is strange. But what? Yes, his name is Mark Friend. And it's at AOL.com.
You just said it out loud.
Okay.
Everyone's going to blow up Mark AOL. Friend's email at AOL.com.
Both my parents are AOL, man. They are loyal to AOL.com.
I don't understand this.
Believe it or not, I read an article recently that they still have like 3 million subscribers on dial-up internet.
That's insane.
I can't even. To think about that is going to make me, I might short circuit and die thinking that 3 million people are on AOL.
Think about how slow that would be.
Travis doesn't even know what that is.
Oh, get out of here. I know exactly. Get out of here. I know what dial-up is. He
wasn't even born when Windows 95 came out.
I just can't wait for the people that are on dial-up to watch this and for me to be like 93 and then like, man, that Travis Teal Page really was making waves in St. Louis back in 2017.
Yes.
So.
All right. Well, thanks for being on the show, man. We really appreciate it. It was
absolutely
fun.
My pleasure, man.
And I want everybody to go get this album. Unless you're a total jerk, you have to buy it. I mean, everybody's doing it.
It's $3.96. Suck it up. Don't have a cup of coffee from Starbucks for one day and just get the album.
Yeah, seriously. And get it from iTunes because it gets more money, you jerks. Seriously. Why do you have an Android phone? What is wrong with you people?
Hey, man. To each his own.
Did that?
To each his own.
No.
I have to say that. I have to say
I know you have to, but I'll step in and I'll take the bullet.
Deal.
Get an iPhone and get on iTunes, you jerks.
Unless, Andrew, you want to sponsor the show, then we're totally cool with it.
Yep. At Google, if you want to give me one of your Google Pixel phones, I'm in. hook me up. Yes. That's the one phone that almost makes me go, I might switch.
Oh, yeah. Oh, like yeah. That. I work at a unnamed tech store that may or may not
has something to do with fruit.
Has something to do with fruit. And there are a couple of my coworkers that have the Pixel, and it is fantastic.
I want it. I'd like to. Yeah. All right. Whole nother show. We're going to go because we're talking way too long, but it's been fun. So thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Go get the album. We missed it. EP. You know where to get it. Go to iTunes or we'll be upset with you. And then we won't let you listen to the show anymore. All five of you go now and get the album. We'll talk to you later. Thanks, guys.
Thank you all.